Welcome back to the MonkeyPesa YouTube channel. Today we'll be talking about Patrick Bitature, one of the wealthiest men in Uganda. Please like, comment, subscribe, turn on notifications to make sure you do not miss similar content in the future. A conversation about wealth distribution in Uganda will usually bring up a familiar cluster of names. One of those popular ones being Patrick Bitature. After losing his father to the tyrannical regime of Idi Amin Dada, one could say a young Patrick Bitature was drawn to business by tragedy. At a tender age of 13, he hitchhiked his way to Kenya to get his then grieving family some sugar, at a period when it was the scarcest of household items in the country. Fast forward more than 40 years, he is lauded as one of the wealthiest people in Uganda, rubbing shoulders with Ugandans of Asian origin and Indian entrepreneurs the likes of Karim Hirij and Sudhir Ruparelia, who also happen to be his mentors. As of 2012, Forbes magazine rated him at a net worth of around $100 million. Patrick Bitature is most popularly known for his proprietorship of Simba Telecom, a company he started in 1998 that ended up becoming a subsidiary of MTN, dealing mostly in reselling MTN airtime. Simba Telecom made sales as high as $80 million in 2010. From his experience with Simba Telecom, he was granted a Vodacom dealership in Tanzania. This venture did not turn out as lucrative as the parent company back home in Uganda, but he speaks about his time in the Tanganyika with pride because of the life and business lessons he learned. He exported his business acumen to Kenya and the lessons from Tanzania paid off. He successfully set out a Safaricom dealership with more than 60 shops in Kenya today. Despite being known mostly for his work in telecom, Patrick Bitature says his wealth mostly emanates from a different venture, property. The businessman says he was introduced to property by his mentor Sudhir Ruparelia, who is the current wealthiest man in Uganda, on one afternoon after they had had lunch together at Speak Hotel. He was introduced to two properties in Chadondo that began his life as a property owner and hasn't looked back ever since. In investing in property, he ended up in debt over 1 billion Uganda shillings. But he says a few years later, each of the properties he invested in that sits on 1 acre or more is worth at least $1.5 million. This is not taking into the consideration properties he owns in other parts of East Africa. He's actually known to have said that Sudhir introduced him to a building he bought for $600 million, which today he would only have to sell doors to pay a bank. Patrick Bitature is also a major player in the energy sector in Uganda. He is the current chairman board of directors of Umeme, the largest energy distributor in Uganda, providing 97% of electricity used in the country. The company is listed on the Uganda Security Exchange and also cross-listed on the Nairobi Stock Exchange, with assets estimated at $670 million. He also runs Electromax Limited, a power company that owns and runs the Tororo Thermal Power Station in Uganda. It was the first private-owned power station in Africa to put out more than 20 megawatts of power. In September 2018, the company signed a contract with the government of Uganda in which they are paid 80 cents for every unit of power they add to the national grid. Tororo Thermal Power Plant currently adds 50 megawatts to the national grid. Through his Simba Group, he also owns Tororo Solar Power Station, whose 10 megawatts of power is sold directly to the national grid. Its power lights up 40,000 homes in the vicinity of the station to reduce on transmission costs. Away from telecom and energy, Patrick also has his hands in the hospitality business. He owns the Kampala Protea Hotel through his Simba Group of companies. The establishment was founded in 2007 and is a member of the South African Best Protea Hotels Group, owned by the Marriott Hotels chain. In December 2014, the hotel won the award for the Best Luxury City Business Hotel in Uganda in the World Luxury Hotels Awards contest that year. It had won a similar award the previous year. It boasts of 59 rooms, 11 suites, one restaurant and many, many more amenities. Under the same chain of hotels, he also owns the Naguru Skies Hotel and the Protea Hotel in Entebbe. He also owns Simba Mining Limited, which is involved in gold mining in Ivanda District, as well as Simba Dairy Farm in Ivanda, which is able to put out upwards of 750 liters of milk per day. About the farm, he said, "I am into this for commercial reasons, and more importantly, to help others do it better, because this is more of a model farm that will help my neighborhood to not only become better dairy farmers, but to also make more money for themselves." In all honesty, we could go on and on and on about his achievements in the business world, but for today, we would like to sign out with what we believe is his biggest piece of advice. When opportunities come, you must be ready. Learn how to leverage your balance sheet, ideas, resources, and network, and you must, of course, work hard, because that gives you 10 times the power you need. Don't forget to like, leave a comment on which personalities you think we should talk about next, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you do not miss more similar content. Thanks for watching.